Hello, namaste to everyone. Today, let's know about the ashwagandha. So, its benefits, its qualities and how to use this, let's know in this video. So, the first one is, what is ashwagandha? What the word meaning means? So, ashwa means horse, gandha means the smell. Which smells like horse is called ashwagandha. The other meaning is which gives strength like a horse, it's called ashwagandha. So, this is very useful to get the strength in your body. Anybody can use it, from the small child to the old elderly persons. So, now let's know the qualities of ashwagandha. So, ashwagandha, usually we use the roots of ashwagandha because it has a lot of medicinal values. So, let's know the qualities. First one, it is ushnavirya, hot in potency, and it is sweet, bitter and astringent in taste. So, and it is light and snigdha, oily in nature. So, it reduces the vata and kapha disorders in our body. So, usually vata disorders means like if you are having any pain, or if you are having flatulence, or if you are having some joint pains, or if you are very much stressed, or you're having any depression, or you're frightened of doing some things, unnecessary getting frightened. So these, when you're having all these problems, you can use this ashwagandha. So now let's know what are the health benefits of ashwagandha. First thing is, it increases your digestion and it is useful in respiratory diseases. It's good for your heart. It's good for your uterine health. It increases your sperm count. It increases your immunity power. And if you are very weak, or if you are having the muscular dystrophy, so these persons can consume this ashwagandha and it will really be helpful for them. And the next thing is, it purifies your blood, it strengthens all the tissues. And anybody like who works hard, who does a lot of physical activity during the day, or a sports person, so these persons can use this ashwagandha daily for a certain period of time. Not daily, just ask your doctor and consume, because it should not be taken for a long time. So the next thing is, it's good for your heart and it decreases the inflammation. So now let's know how to use it. Okay, when you're having any respiratory problems, then early in the morning at the empty stomach, you have to consume half teaspoon powder with 2 teaspoon of ghee and 1 teaspoon of honey. So keep in mind that honey and ghee should not be taken in equal quantity. So 2 teaspoon of ghee, 1 teaspoon of honey and 1/2 teaspoon of churna. Just mix it and you can have it in the empty stomach in the morning. So you can have it twice a day. Even in the evening you can take it. So it will decrease your cough and respiratory problems. So when you're having any skin irritation or any skin infections, you can mix this churna with the milk powder, with the milk, and just apply it over the skin when it dries off, or you can keep it for 1 hour. Then after, when it dries off after 1 hour, you can just wash it. So when you consume this, it works as anti-aging also. So it's good for your skin glowing also. So the next thing is for the uterine problems. So when you're having any uterine problems, to make your uterus strong, so you can use this ashwagandha powder. So how to prepare this? So first one is, you have to take 5 grams of ashwagandha powder, add 2 teaspoon of ghee, add 250 ml of water, 250 ml of milk, and just boil it. After few minutes, you can consume this milk. So this is good for your uterus. In Ayurvedic shops, you get ashwagandha churna, ashwagandha leha, ashwagandha rasayana, ashwagandha vati, ashwagandha arishta. So consult your Ayurvedic physician and consume it. One more thing you have to keep in mind is, it increases the pitta. So the pitta prakriti person should consume ashwagandha less. And in summer, you have to consume this little quantity. So to decrease, and one more thing is, to decrease this pitta, we use ghee or guduchi or milk along with the ashwagandha. So its pitta effect decreases. So this is all about ashwagandha. Let's meet in the next video. Thank you.